Hi, my name is Cindy Farr, and I'm the incident commander for the COVID-19 response for the Missoula City County Health Department. Today is Friday, April 10th, and this is my daily briefing. We've gotten some feedback from some of you out there that the way that we are reporting our numbers is a little bit confusing, so we're going to try reporting those numbers in a different way starting today, and hopefully that will clear up any confusion. We've had a total of 28 people who have tested positive for COVID-19 in Missoula County. 22 of those people have now recovered, and that means that we still have 6 active cases in isolation. We're also monitoring over 120 people who have been quarantined as close contacts to confirmed cases. The state of Montana has had a total of 365 cases, and there have been 6 deaths in the state, with 1 in our county. The reason I emphasize these numbers this morning is that I think people are under the impression that we don't have a lot of cases, and that that means that we don't have the potential for a lot of spread in Missoula County, and that this is almost over. We have low numbers because we've taken measures to manage the spread and limit this from getting worse. However, the potential for high numbers and spread is very much there if we don't continue to work together. The last several of our cases that have been confirmed have actually been community spread, and what that means is that they were not brought into our community by means of travel, and they were not close contacts to other cases. And that what that tells me is that there are probably cases out there that we don't know about. Which leads me into the next thing that I want to talk about, which is testing supplies. For those of you who watched the governor's press conference yesterday, I'm sure that you feel like you're getting mixed messages, because they said on their press conference that there are plenty of test supplies out there for people to be able to get tested. And what I want to clarify is that what they're talking about when they say that there are plenty of test kits is that they're talking about the testing ability at the lab level. And when we're talking about testing supplies, we're talking about supplies including the little swab that goes in your nose and the vial that it needs to go into in order to get transported to the lab to get tested. And what we're finding is that we are all experiencing in our medical community, we're experiencing a shortage of those kinds of supplies. We're experiencing it firsthand, trying to order supplies for our testing clinic. We started our clinic with enough supplies to sample about 200 people, but then we placed an order to replenish those supplies, and we thought it was going to be in by the end of this week. We were going to have 3,000 kits in order to take samples and send them up to the lab, and that supply order has now been backordered, and we're not really sure when we're going to get it. So we're having to look for other sources for those kinds of supplies. So if you go to a testing clinic and they tell you that they can't test you because the supplies are limited, they're looking at the resources that they have available. They're looking at your risk of severe illness and using the CDC's guidance to make decisions. There's still resource issues on the provider side, and even if the state lab has what they need to process the samples, we're still having a hard time getting the supplies that we need to collect the samples in the first place. So I just want to make it clear that those are two completely different things that are being talked about, and that's why it seems like you're getting a mixed message. One of the most frequent questions that we get is, when will the cases in Missoula peak? The answer is, it's really hard to say. The peak is easy to see in hindsight. For example, in other areas of the world that are seeing a downturn in the cases, it's easy to figure out where they peaked, but predicting the peak is a lot harder. Yes, there are lots of models out there right now trying to figure this out. However, each model gives us different information. Some models will have us peaking in the next couple of weeks, others not until the third week of June. The reason for these differences are numerous. Each model has a slightly different approach, uses different assumptions, and the data that we have right now is just really limited. Another variable that we're seeing about COVID-19 as a virus is learning about how it spreads or how our immunity works, and whether this virus will come as a single peak or if it's going to be coming in waves like the 1918 flu. However, one of the biggest variables in predicting the peak and the virus's impact are human factors. Models based on how other countries or states handled the virus may not inform a model for Montana. And human behavior, like adherence to social distancing practices and stay-at-home orders, have a profound impact on the number of cases that we see, when we peak, and how flat our curve actually stays. So the honest and yet very dissatisfying answer is that we just don't know when we're going to peak yet based on the data that we have now. And even if we knew when the peak was going to come, it may not tell us when this is going to be over. Models can give us ideas of how things can look for planning purposes, but they really aren't that crystal ball that we all wish that we had that can give us definitive answers. One thing that's really important to remember, and something that the models do show, is that our behavior is what is going to determine how successful we are at fighting this disease. Adherence to the social distancing, staying at home whenever possible, working with essential services to minimize exposure is vital for everyone. From what we can see, these measures are working based on the changes in the rates of infection in the hardest hit cities in the United States. But that doesn't mean that we can get complacent, nor does it mean that following the stay-at-home order isn't important. It also means that when we get to a point where we can start reopening things, we have to be really smart about how we do it. We will likely have to do things very gradually, and some behavior change may need to be sustained for a while. What we do know from past pandemic responses is how important this is. During the 1918 flu, right here in Missoula, public health and local health officials took steps to prevent congregating, including closing schools, churches, preventing patrons from hanging out in bars. The measures to promote social distancing did help mitigate the disease. However, behavior changes were not sustained. So after World War I ended, people disregarded the cautions about congregating, and there was a second wave of illness and deaths from the flu. So some of the key takeaways that I just want to emphasize from my briefing this morning is we're learning more about this virus every single day, and it informs and sometimes changes how we're responding to it. The models are great tools, but no one model can really give us the exact answer as to when this disease is going to peak here in Missoula, or if it's going to come in waves, or when all of this is going to eventually be over. Human behavior is one of the biggest variables in figuring out what that curve is going to look like, and human behavior is one of the hardest things to predict. However, it is also one of our best tools in flattening this curve, so we want to be able to decrease our cases and prevent later spikes in disease. We will need to assess and be really smart about how and when we reopen and reintroduce activities into our daily lives. And some behavior changes will need to be sustained for longer so that we don't have a huge spike in cases when we do start gradually reopening things. I don't want anyone to think that since we're currently seeing low numbers, then lower numbers than what were originally projected, that it's time for complacency or a sign that this was not a big deal. You just need to look at the other places that either didn't have the chance to put those social distancing measures into place or chose not to be able to see where things could have been. So I just want to say thank you to everyone in our Missoula community for all the good work and the sacrifices that you've made up to this point to try and keep this peak from being really big and happening all of a sudden in Missoula. Just please sustain these measures to prevent a surge in cases. When we can provide additional information and guidance to you, we definitely will do that. We want to be as transparent as we can be here in public health and give you as much information and guidance as we can to help us all fight this disease. So again, thank you for everything that you're doing out there. Please continue to maintain the social distancing. I know it's really hard. We've had a really beautiful weather week here in Missoula. And so it's really hard for us to say, you know, okay, we're not going to go back to our normal thing and getting together with friends and having barbecues. It's hard for everyone, but it is really important to continue to sustain those social distancing measures that we've talked about. I hope everyone has had an opportunity to get outside and take a walk this week and enjoy our beautiful weather as we're about to have our second or maybe third wave of winter this spring, starting this weekend. So do what you can today to get a little vitamin D and sunshine and fresh air, because it's about to get a little bit colder and nastier outside. And that's the end of my daily briefing. So as always, you can certainly subscribe to me on YouTube. That's under Cindy Farr, CindyFarr. Click that notification bell so that you can get notified when other videos are uploaded. Follow us on Facebook at the Missoula City County Health Department. You can call our 258-INFO or 258-4636 in order to determine if you are a candidate for getting a test through our drive-through testing facility. You can call that number if you have any general questions about COVID-19. You can also call that number if you have questions about what resources might be available to you, such as rental assistance or assistance getting food supplies. So that's definitely a good resource for you. You can also find more information on our Missoula County website at missoula.co/cvirus. I hope everyone has a great weekend. Stay well, and I will talk to you all again on Monday.